In order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America.
These immortal words, when first they were written, proclaimed to the world an idea new among men. This was the American dream, the prayer for the future. We pay tribute here, not to a man who lived a century ago, but to an individual who lives today in the hearts of all freedom-loving people. His prophetic words are as valid for our time as they were for his. And now, the skills of the sculptor and the talents of the artist will let us relive great moments with Mr. Lincoln.
The world has never had a good definition of the word liberty. The American people just now are much in want of one. We all declare for liberty, but in using the same word, we do not all mean the same thing. What constitutes the bulwark of our liberty and independence? It is not our frowning battlements, our bristling seacoasts. These are not our reliance against tyranny. Our reliance is in the love of liberty, which God has planted in our bosom. Our defense is in the preservation of the spirit which prizes liberty as the heritage of all men, in all lands, everywhere. Destroy this spirit, and you have planted the seeds of despotism around your own door. At what point shall we expect the approach of danger? By what means shall we fortify against it? Shall we expect some transatlantic military giant to step the ocean and crush us in a blow? No. All the armies of Europe, Asia, and Africa combined could not by force take a drink from the Ohio, or make a track on the Blue Ridge in a trial of 1,000 years. At what point, then, is the approach of danger to be expected? I answer that if it ever reaches, it must spring from amongst us. It cannot come from abroad. If destruction be our lot, we ourselves must be the authors and finishers. As a nation of free men, we must live through all time, or die by suicide. Neither let us be slandered from our duty by false accusations against us, or frightened from it by menaces of destruction to the government, nor of dungeons to ourselves. Let us have faith that right makes right, and in that faith, let us to the end dare to do our duty as we understand.